Your new album.
Yes.
Three words.
Three words.
Three words indeed. Sum it up in three words.
Sum it up in three words. Exciting, fresh, unexpected.
And unexpected. Mm. So has Ashley been listening to it?
Ashley's obsessed with it.
When you get
an album from the record company, you have to keep tighter hold of it because it's always a fear that things are going to be leaked. And I have to actually physically hide the album from Ashley. It's quite embarrassing.
So you worked with Will.i.am from the Black Eyed Peas on the album. How did you meet him?
Girls Aloud did a programme called Passions, where we all embarked on different things that we felt passionate about other than Girls Aloud. And mine was street dancing.
Yeah.
So at the end of each girl's passion, there would be like some sort of a finale. I heard Heartbreaker. They suggested I could be in the video as my finale. Then Will suggested I could put vocals on top of that. So it kind of became like a featuring. And I danced in the Heartbreaker video and made him just connected there, really. We just had a spark, and hey presto, here we are.
You look fantastic.
Thank you.
No, style icon.
Oh.
How does that mantle sit with you? Because you've always been kind of the girl next door, really. You've been our girl, you know.
No, I don't see myself as a style icon or put myself out there as a style icon at all. Don't get me wrong, it's lovely that people enjoy what I wear and they like what I wear and stuff. I remember when I first did the X Factor auditions last year, just thinking, oh, let me get some lovely little frocks, you know, like, let me get some nice little outfits for this. But then all of a sudden they started writing about it and stuff, and then it all changed from there, really, and I was like, God, people really care that I wear a dress, like a nice dress on. Yeah, it's still a bit strange for me.
What about a move to LA, which I suppose is an inevitable question to ask someone like your good self, who's fast becoming a global brand? LA seems like a natural next step, if you like.
And no, not for me. It doesn't feel like that for me, not right now, anyway.
Even though you made a lot of the album out there?
I made the album out there and I loved it. I felt free. I felt like, God, I can really breathe and, like, nobody really cares who I am, nobody really wants an autograph. It's quite nice sometimes to have that. So, no plans to move it out there just yet, but I like to go there to escape.
You also keep in touch with the girls. What are they up to this year?
All the girls are doing different things. Kimberly's doing some bits of presenting. Nicola's doing a makeup range. That's for the paler skinned woman. Sarah's just shot the new St. Trinian's movie, and Nadine, I believe, is in LA recording a solo album as well as I am.
So we can look forward to that. And
yes.
I gather 2010, because it's obviously not over for Girls Aloud, I promise, of course, was the Brit Award winner this year, wasn't it?
It's like, took 6 years, well, 6 years then, to win a Brit. That was one of the highlights of this year. And by November, we'll have been together 7 years.
That's what happens when you promise, honey.
Yeah.
Promise, Andy.
Will you make a promise?
Will I make a promise? You stick together.
Yes.